Julian Schnabel's paintings became a focus of attention on the New York art scene in the early 1980s. Along with the attention his work attracted, came a degree of hype and personal stardom. His personality became as known as his work. Later, though, media and the critics turned their attention elsewhere.
There's a funny line in a book I wrote, when the nice thing about New York City is you can always start over as somebody else. Well, that's just because people will never notice when you go away and when you come back.
Now Schnabel is once again creating a splash, this time with his films. The Diving Bell and the Butterfly earned him the Best Director Award at this year's Cannes Film Festival.
I don't think I reinvented anything. I think that's I think we look for different versions of ourselves every day in whatever we do. And you turn that into art.
He makes no major distinction between his paintings and his movies. Both are works he creates as an artist.
There are things that I can address in film that I wouldn't want to address in painting. I mean, the two separate, they have separate ways of mediating themselves into the public.
When Julian Schnabel started out as a painter, he was known for painting on broken pieces of plates, and later on all kinds of surfaces, including tarp, kabuki theater backdrops, and velvet. Like his personality, his paintings are imposing and have a raw, energetic force, always large and at the center of attention. His extraordinary ego has both helped and hurt him in his career. Many New York and European critics have said that his flashy, flamboyant public persona often overshadows his work. But as he gets more eloquent with the language of films, he has managed to win over another group of critics, critics of film.
After my father died, I tried to make this film, or I did make this film, The Diving Bell and the Butterfly, somehow to come to grips with his death and help people try to understand how to deal with their interior life, how to deal with death.
The Diving Bell and a Butterfly is based on a memoir by a former editor of the French version of Elle magazine. He had suffered a stroke that paralyzed his entire body, except his left eye, which he used to blink out his book. Schnabel's other two films are Before Night Falls, a biography of Cuban poet Reinaldo Arenas, a gay artist who created a stirring body of work, even under censorship and persecution by his government, for his poetry and sexual orientation. And Basquiat, which tells the story of the rise and early death of Jean-Michel Basquiat, a New York-based graffiti artist. All three of his films are about the creation of art under extreme circumstances.
I think that there's some kind of a search for some kind of truth that I could present in these films. So I try to make them authentic. I think we all are facing overwhelming difficulties. I mean, you're going to die. You're going to get old. You're going to die. You're going to get sick. Your children are going to die. What you need to do is to understand that, I believe, and just to kind of appreciate what your life is and make something out of it. And if you're lucky enough to be privileged, then it's your responsibility to sort of do things for other people. I think making a work of art is an act of peace. It's a life-affirming act, whether you're making a film or making a drawing. Summer of 1995, a friend of mine was riding on a motorcycle, and it was raining and it was very slippery, so he pulled over to the side and he didn't hear this Alfa Romeo that was sort of that was coming along the side and hit him and dragged him for 300 meters, and So he was killed there, and I made the St. Paolo Amalfi paintings. So he was converted into art.
There have been a few touring retrospectives of Schnabel's work in recent years. Critics are again split over its merits and whether it transcends the 80s. Schnabel shrugs off these concerns as a passing annoyance.
I'm reinventing every day a way of looking at painting for myself. The idea of somebody being an artist of the 80s or the 90s or whatever, that's just silly.
For now, he continues to focus on his exploration of the process of art making, a theme so prevalent in his films. Quoting film director Andrei Tarkovsky.
Artistic creation is by definition a denial of death.
Therefore it is optimistic.
It was very nice.
Even if in an ultimate sense, the artist is tragic. And so, there can never be optimistic artists and pessimistic artists. There can only be talent and mediocrity.